individual taxpayers having taxable annual income up to rupees 5 lakhs will get full tax rebate. Required to pay any tax. As a result, even persons having gross income up to rupees 6.5 lakhs may not be required to pay any income tax if they make investments in provident funds, specified savings, insurance, etc. 6.5 lakh tak jab aap ye investment karte ho to 6.5 lakh tak bhi koi tax nahi aayega agar aap investment karte ho specified savings. In fact, with additional deductions such as interest on home loan up to 2 lakhs, interest on educational loans, national pension scheme contributions, medical insurance, medical expenditure on senior citizens, with all of these other exemptions, deductions, persons having even higher income will not have to pay any tax. The period of 2008 to 2014 will be remembered as a period of aggressive credit growth, and as per RBI, the primary reason for a spurt in non-performing loans and stressed assets. Outstanding loans of public sector banks ballooned from 18 lakh crore to 52 lakh crore during this period. Many projects were started that could either not be completed or had low capacity utilization, resulting in their inability to pay back these loans. They were high stressed and non-performing assets amounting to rupees 5.4 lakh crore in 2014, even though they were not being recognized as NPA at that point of time. Many more were hidden through restructuring or otherwise, which were discovered during the asset quality reviews and inspections carried out since 2015. Hamare sarkar mein India ko kahe ke ye sabhi loans ko dekhe aur banko ki sahi sthiti desh ke samne rakhe. Over 98% rural sanitation coverage and as many as 5,45,000 village education free. It is a holistic program and has succeeded in changing the mindset of our people. We launched the world's largest healthcare program. Ayushman Bharat, to provide medical treatment. Lagbhag 3000 crore rupees aise gareeb aur madhyam vargiya parivaron ke bache hain jis jo ye 10 lakh logon ko ilaaj mila muft mein. Lakho gareeb madhyam vargiyon ko is baat ka bhi labh ho raha hai jo keemte kam hui dawaiyon mein, cardiac stent mein, knee implants mein. Aur aaj dawaiyan jan pradhanmantri jan aushadhi kendra mein बहुत ही सस्ते दरों पे मिल जाती है. इससे लाखों करोड़ों लोगों को लाभ मिलता है. There are 21 aims operating or being established in the country presently. 14 of these 21 aims have been announced since 2014. दो तिहाई हमने इस सरकार आने के बाद शुरू किया. आज मुझे खुशी है आप सबको बताते हुए कि जो 22वां एम्स है अब मेरे राज्य में जहां मेरा परिवार जहां से आता है हरियाणा में अब 22वां एम्स लगने जा रहा है. मैडम स्पीकर, हमारे मेहनती किसानों को फसल का पूरा मूल्य नहीं मिलता था. हमारी सरकार ने किसानों की आय दुगुनी करने हेतु इतिहास में पहली बार सभी 22 फसलों का न्यूनतम समर्थन मूल्य MSP लागत से कम 50% अधिक निर्धारित किया। Agriculture continues to be the main driver of the rural economy. Our hard-working farmers, supported by the pro-farmer policies of our government in the past 4.5 years, have produced agriculture commodities in record quantities. Declining prices of agricultural commodities in the international market and fall in food inflation in India since the last 2 years relative to the non-food sector have, however, reduce the returns from farming. Small and fragmented land holding on account of repeated divisions has also contributed in decline in the income of the farmer family. Hence, and marginal farmers, chote aur siman jo kisan hain, unko ek prakar se unki aay mein aur tej gati se badhe aur ek samarthan dene ke hetu, Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi PM किसान नाम की एक ऐतिहासिक योजना इस सरकार ने मंजूरी की है। PM किसान इस योजना के तहत जो वल्नरेबल किसान हैं, जो छोटी जमीन रखते हैं, 2 हेक्टेयर तक की जिनकी जमीन है, 2 हेक्टेयर तक की जमीन को उन सभी को सीधा उनके इनकम में सपोर्ट, डायरेक्ट इनकम सपोर्ट 6000 रुपए प्रति वर्ष के हिसाब से देने का निर्णय सरकार ने किया है। दिस इनकम सपोर्ट विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड डायरेक्टली इनटू द बैंक अकाउंट्स ऑफ बेनिफिशियरी फार्मर्स इन 3 equal installments ऑफ ₹2000 ईच। दिस प्रोग्राम विल बी फंडेड 100% by the government of India. करीब 12 करोड़ किसान परिवारों का इससे सीधा लाभ मिलेगा। प्रोग्राम 1 दिसंबर 2018 से ही लागू किया जाएगा और पहली किश्त ₹2000 की जल्द ही सूचियां बना के उनके खाते में भेजी जाए। इस कार्यक्रम का अनुमानित खर्चा ₹75,000 करोड़ सालाना सरकार भरेगी। Fisheries sector also need considerable support. I have increased the allocation for Rashtriya Gokul Mission to 750 crores in the current year itself. I am also very happy, Madam Speaker, to announce the setting up of Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog to upscale sustainable genetic upgradation of cow resources and to enhance production and productivity of cows. The Ayog will also look after effective implementation of laws and welfare schemes for cows. In addition to the health coverage provided under Ayushman Bharat and life and disability coverage provided under Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana and Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, our government proposes to launch a mega pension yojana, namely Pradhan Mantri Shram-Yogi Mandhan. Pradhan Mantri Shram-Yogi Mandhan will be for the organized sector workers with monthly income up to ₹15,000. This pension yojana shall provide them an assured monthly pension of ₹3,000 after they achieve the age of 60 years. On a monthly contribution, affordable amount during their working age, an unorganized sector worker joining the pension yojana at the age of 29 years will only have to contribute 100 rupees per month till he attains the age of 60 years. A worker joining the pension yojana at 18 years of age will only have to contribute 55 rupees per month. Proud of the hard warriors of our youth. In order to take the benefits of artificial intelligence and related technologies to the people, a national program on artificial intelligence has been envisaged by our government. This would be catalyzed by the establishment of the National Center on Artificial Intelligence as a hub along with centers of excellence. 9 priority areas have been identified. A national artificial intelligence portal will be developed soon. In our election manifesto, we had promised to implement one rank, one pension. This was pending for the last 40 years, but has been resolved by us. Madam Speaker, previous governments announced it in 3 budgets, but sanctioned a mere 500 crore rupees in the interim budget of 2014-15. In contrast, we have already disbursed over 35,000 crore rupees. After implementing the scheme in true spirit, 35,000 crore rupees sarkar ne pichle varshon mein hamare jawanon ke liye diye hain one rank one pension ke tehat. The government has also announced substantial hike in the military service pay of all service personnel and special allowances given to naval and air force personnel deployed in high risk areas. Our defense budget, Madam Speaker, ye hum sab ke liye khushi ki baat hai ki is varsh pehli baar hamara defense budget 3 lakh crore se badh ke 2019-20 mein pravdhan kiya gaya hai. For securing our borders and to maintain preparedness of the highest order, if necessary, additional funds will also be provided. Aaj ek samanya nagrik bhi udan yojana ke karan hawai jahaj mein safar kar pa raha hai. Ab 100 se adhik airport ho gaye hain. सिक्किम में पाक्योंग एयरपोर्ट खुलने के बाद 100 से अधिक एयरपोर्ट इस देश में हो गए, ऑपरेशनल एयरपोर्ट्स. डोमेस्टिक पैसेंजर ट्रैफिक दुगना हुआ है पिछले 5 वर्षों में, दुगना. और क्या जब इतनी तेज गति से विकास होगा तो स्वाभाविक रूप से नौकरियां भी आएंगी और एविएशन सेक्टर में बड़े रूप में युवा युवकों को नौकरियों का साधन मिला है. Today, India is the fastest highway developer in the whole world. With 27 kilometers of highways built each day, Indian Railways has experienced the safest year in its history. All unmanned level crossings. Aap sab gaur kariye. All unmanned level crossings on broad gauge network have been completely eliminated. Aaj pure desh mein ek bhi unmanned level crossing broad gauge network pe bacha nahi hai. Introduction of the first indigenously developed and manufactured semi high speed Vande Bharat Express will give the Indian passengers world class experience with speed, service and safety. This major leap in wholly developed technology by our engineers will East have also received significant benefits of infrastructure development. Arunachal Pradesh came on the air map recently, and Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram have come on India's rail map for the first time. Allocation for the northeastern areas is being proposed to be increased by 21% to rupees 58,166 crore over 2018-19 budget estimates. Our government is committed to eliminating the ills of black money from our country. The anti-black money measures taken by us during the last 4.5 years in the form of black money law, the Fugitive Criminal Offenders Act and demonetization have brought undisclosed income of about 1,30,000 crore to tax, led to seizure and attachment of assets worth approximately 50,000 crores, and compelled holders of large cash currency to disclose their source of earnings. During this period, Benami assets worth rupees 6,900 crore and foreign assets worth rupees 1,600 crore have also been attached. As many as 3,38,000 shell companies have been detected and deregistered, and their directors disqualified. Growth of 18% in direct tax collection in 2017-18, an increase in tax base by as many as 1,06,000 people filing income tax returns for the first time in the financial year 17-18.